In this video, I'm going to cover enhancements, improvements in the new Smart Designer Pro 1.16.14.05 service pack. So the first thing I want to show you is something that we've added to the template browser. I'm going to go over here to templates. I'm going to select the template browser. You're going to notice that there's a new button in the template browser, and this new button says graphics cast, check for updates. What this is, it's a way for us to deploy content. So what you'll see in the future is a premium content subscription that'll be made available. But currently, right now, we have a way of deploying the content from the campus apparel marketing system using this particular technology in Smart Designer Pro. And you'll notice it says campus apparel update quarters 3 and 4. Anyone that's an active subscriber to campus apparel can get a new serial number from their Smart Designer, and that new serial number, what that will do, it will enable you to have access to these downloads. So instead of having to go and manually download the templates every month, you'll be able to download quarterly updates. It'll automatically install all the fonts, all the templates, and everything right directly into Smart Designer. It does require an active subscription, and it does require a new serial number. You can request a new serial number for your Smart Designer Pro if you're a Campus Apparel subscriber just by going to our main contact form on our digitalartsolutions.com website. So if I have that active subscription, I can go ahead and just double click on this. It's going to download an installer, run the installer, and then all of the templates are going to show up right inside of Smart Designer. So we have a new download that is all of the templates from Campus Apparel for quarter 3 and 4. So if you're an active Campus Apparel subscriber, you can go to the graphics cast, you can download that, and it's going to deploy all of the templates from Campus Apparel for the first two quarters, which is quarter 3 and quarter 4 of 2013. It even installs all the sales flyers as well. So that's a new feature that we've added for Campus Apparel subscribers, and then we'll also use that feature in the future for deploying artwork through a premium content subscription. So that's the first thing. Second thing you'll see is if I come down here and I go to Clipart and Graphics and I launch the Clipart browser, you're going to see a new button in the Clipart browser. The new button says Database. And if I click on this button, what it's going to do, it's going to download and install the latest version of the Smart Designer database for any of our new art volumes. So if we introduce a new art volume, this is the way that we're going to go ahead and update the database so that the software knows that there's new content. And I'm going to recommend that everyone runs that function. There's been some changes made to that database. You want to run that function and update the database, and that's a new function we've added. Also, if we go over to Athletic Tails, one of the features that's been requested is the split tail function. This is a function that people use for doing split front baseball jerseys. It was a feature that we couldn't put into the original version of Smart Designer Pro because some technical changes in CorelX 6 didn't let us use that old user interface. So we've brought this feature back, actually a better version of this feature. It's a lot simpler for people to use. And let me show you how this works. I'm just going to create an athletic tail here real quick. And during the tail process, you'll notice I'm going to get a prompt to make this connection point, and you'll notice it's doing the little weight here. It's allowing me to do that adjustment. So we have the athletic tail, and what I want to do is I want to split this tail, but I want to have a section of this overlapping. And the reason I want to have a section of this overlapping is I might have a button front baseball jersey, and I want the button part to be completely filled with the tail, and then underneath the button I want that filled with the graphic as well. That's called a split front. So the way we can do that is there's a new feature. If I go over here to Object Shaping, you can see it says Split Front. I can have either a horizontal or a vertical split, so I could split it this direction or in the horizontal direction. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click over here, and I'm just going to click on horizontal, and I'm just going to click a little button right there, and then I'm going to click right here next to it. That's my split point. And the software is going to automatically create that split. So if you can see this, there's actually a duplicate section here. If you go into wireframe view, you can really see that. So there's a duplicate section. So I don't know how we could really make that feature any easier. It does produce some guidelines. If you want to get rid of those, you can just click on it with your left mouse button, hit delete. Click on it, left mouse button, hit delete. If you're going to actually cut this in vinyl, you can take these and spread them apart here. And you could do that if you're going to cut it in vinyl or digitize this for an applique as well. So that's one thing. Now another thing that we did under sizing and arranging, and I'm going to exit the wireframe view, and you notice over here I have a little shortcut key on my toolbar. It says toggle views. I'm going to click on toggle views there. If I go over here to sizing and arranging, and I click on size design, what we've done is we've added an enhancement in there. And so we've added some checkboxes, and one of the checkboxes that we've added is resize page if smaller. So if the page is smaller than the ultimate size of the graphic when it's resized, what this feature is going to do, it's going to resize the page. But we did something else, which is if you go over here to the settings tab and you click on global values, you can put a page offset value. So I've put in 1 inch for width and 1 inch for height. And what that's going to do is when I go over here and assign this to an adult size, it's going to resize my page and give me a 1 inch margin all the way around. And so that's another new feature that we've added. A couple other small enhancements that we've added. Something that's quite popular to do is what we call vector fills or power clip fills. I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to create some text here. And I'm going to pick a different font. So use the good old Game Day font here. And I'm going to make this pink. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here and I'm going to go to the Command Center. I'm going to go down here to Effects. I'm going to go to Quick Fills. And we've added an enhancement to the Quick Fills. So we have what's called Power Clip Effects. So Power Clip Effects are effects that if you click on these, these are going to power clip that effect into the actual graphic. So let's say I want to do like a particular pattern, or let's say I'm going to go and do, we'll do it this way. I'm going to go over here to Vectors, and I'm just going to select a zebra print. So right there, I'm just going to double click on zebra print, and you'll notice when I did the zebra print, it's taken that zebra print and power clipped it into the graphic. The problem is, it's no longer, doesn't have vector properties for vinyl cutting. So you can see that there's no vector properties. That's a byproduct of the power clipping function in CorelDRAW. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cruise over here and click on Power Clips. And there's a little button here called Convert Fill to Curves. I'm going to click on that. And then what it's done is it's taken that and converted that to an actual vector object. So I can cut that in vinyl now. Now that's a feature that's been in Smart Designer, but it's been under Object Shaping and Convert Fills to Curves, but we added that button right into the Quick Fill section. And so you can do that with any kind of power clip. And I'm going to exit wireframe view so you guys can see what's going on. So this can be cut in vinyl. So if I wanted, I had pink flock, and I cut the pink layer in pink flock, and then the surface layer, maybe I wanted to cut that out in black thermoflex vinyl. We could stack those right directly on top of each other. So that's a new feature. Another thing that we've done, we've brought back the stitch effect. And stitch effect's kind of cool. I'm just going to go over here and create a little design for you, show you how this works. I'll do the same thing. I'm going to use that Game Day font. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to blow this up a little bit, and we'll make this good old USA colors. So we'll make it red. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a contour layer to this. So I'll show you how I can do a contour. Just go over here and grab the contour function. And I'm going to drag a contour line out here, just drag it, and I'm going to make that blue, so up here on the property bar. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate these out, so this is a separate object. So arrange, convert to break contour group apart, and now these are totally separate. So what I want to do is I want to make this look like a simulated applique. So the way I can do that, I'm going to hit F4 so I can see this. I'm going to go over here, I'm going to select the center part right there. And then I'm going to go over here to Effects, and I'm going to select Special Effects, and then I'm going to go over here to Miscellaneous, and then you'll see the last effect. This is a new effect. It says Stitch Effect, and I can pick a color for this, so I'm probably going to pick white, and so I'll just pick white for the Stitch Effect, and I can also add a highlight if I want. And then you put in a parameter for your thickness of your line and what's called stitch length. So you can change that stitch. And all you have to do is just click on Apply, and it's going to go ahead and apply a virtual stitch to this. Now, this isn't a real embroidery stitch. This is just an effect for making something look like an applique. And so if you take a look at that, it looks just like an applique. Cool little trick that you can do if you want to have that go right to the edge, all you do is just select the center part. And I know that I have that, that's the red I was using. I'm just going to right click on that red to give it an outline. And then I'm just going to thicken that outline a little bit. And that's going to actually expand the width of that. And now it looks like that applique goes right to the edge. And I can do the same thing on the other layer too. So I can just grab this layer, do the same thing on there. Go ahead and add that. So create that. I'm just going to select the blue again and make that blue. And I'm just going to put a three-point outline on there again. There you go, and you have a simulated applique. So it's a very cool feature, great for digital printing. You can screen print these with high-density ink or puff ink. They look just like applique. It was a very popular feature in an earlier version of Smart Designer, and so we brought that feature back. Let's see, what else we have here? So we also have a couple things that we've added. If you come down here to Activation, you'll notice we have a new activation engine. And so if I click for check for updates, just click on that. If there was an update available to the software, it would automatically check our server, check your version number, and then it would prompt you to download that update and install it. So we have a new updated engine, and also there's a new subscription status. So you can see here under subscription that I have a special serial number enabling my Smart Designer Pro to work with my campus apparel. You notice that says yes, and also it says premium subscription, says no. We haven't implemented the premium content subscription yet, but that's something that we're currently working on. If you want to see your version number, you can always go to program versions. It says right there 1.16.14.05. So those are the main enhancements and improvements we've made with this new service patch. Always striving to improve the software, give you a better user experience. We've gone in and fixed a couple problems that people could complain about. There was an issue with outline widths and the separation marks. We changed that so you had a little bit more control over that. So we're always listening to you guys, always trying to come up with new, fresh ideas and improvements. And this is the latest version of Smart Designer Pro. And that concludes this video.